Hello, today we are going to learn how to install and run Drone Engage software on Raspberry Pi Zero. First, we open the website and we click on Download Binaries. This is the folder that contains the Raspberry Pi Zero software. Expected in future to find other folders for other Raspberry Pis and other versions. Let's extract it. Here it is, the file. Okay, now we want to copy this file to Raspberry Pi Zero. I expect you have a Raspberry Pi Zero connected to your desktop and accessible via SSH. You can copy the file using FTP, but for me it's easier to copy using SSH. scp.drone.ui, and this is my Raspberry Pi address. Here it is. Okay. Now let's connect to Raspberry Pi and start the actual installation process. Here it is, the file. We need to unzip it using unzip. Here it is. Here we have two files, package.zip and the script. The next thing we need to do is to change the executable, give the script execute the permission. Fine. Now we need to execute this script. The first thing that this script do, that this script does, is that it installs a library called libboost. Then it installs the binaries. Before installing the binaries, it will ask you for a confirmation. Okay, libboost in my Raspberry Pi is already installed. Now it is asking for confirmation. Why? Because it will copy some config files. So if you have already your own config files, it will be overwritten. So if this is an upgrade to Drone Engage, imagine you are installing version 2, for example, then it's recommended to take backups before proceeding these steps. Okay, yes. Now it copied these files, the readme file, the service files, and this is the setting files, the configuration file I was talking about, and this is the binary file. Now it created services for these two binaries. And this service, in short, it ensures that whenever you restart your Raspberry Pi, it will run these applications. Okay. Now we have finished. Let's see what we have here on root. We don't need this file anymore. Let's remove it. We also don't need this file, don't need this file. So now we have readme file that describes the process that I just told you here. And we have this folder contains two subfolders, the communication binary and the mavlink binary. We need to go to both folders to adjust the configuration files. First, let's go to the mavlink file, cde mavlink. Okay, ls. Let's open this file. We can use nano for example. Okay, for startup users, for beginners, we don't need to change these fields. Also, these fields you don't need to change it. What you want to focus on is this area, the connection. You can use a serial port connection, which is the default, is to use dev serial 0 or dev serial 1, and you adjust the boot rate. You can also use a UDP connection, because Raspberry Pi Zero already have a Wi-Fi. So if you're running a board that already has a Wi-Fi, such as the Opal board, for example, or any other Raspberry Pi based Arduino board, then you can connect using a UDP connection. Anyway, let's focus now on the serial connection. Serial connection, all you need to do is to point to the serial port you are using. Here I am using serial port 0, and I define the boot rate. Again, you don't need to edit these files, these parameters at all. This is for advanced usage, and we will come to it later. Now let's go to the other file. Now I went to the drone engage communicator. I want to open the configuration file of drone engage communicator. And again, we don't need to change this, and we don't need to change this. We do need to change this. As I mentioned in another video, drone engage is still using android.com. That's why we are sharing the same server, so you can connect using the mobile or using Raspberry Pi and still can interact with each other. Now to the username and password. These are the username and password that you use in Android. Okay, if you are new to this system and you don't know what Android is, you can create your own username and password from Drone Engage website. You can go here, account manage, press account management here. Here it is, and I can create. I give it an email here, and press access code. 3, 4, 7. Created successfully. Here it is. Here it is, the access code. So I can use this access code here. And I can use this email. I do encourage you to use real email, not temp emails, because sometimes we need to publish some news about Android or about Drone Engage, and sometimes we want to tell you about downtimes or some new updates. So it's much better to use an email that we can communicate back to you with. Okay, anyway, now we have set up the connection to internet. We can close this. And now let's go back. We don't need this either. Now let's go back and open Android or open Drone Engage web client. I said Android web client because until now you can open any of them and they are both connected to each other. Okay, allow. Now I will use this email here. And I will use this password or access code, connect. Now I am connected as a ground station to this web client, Drone Engage web client. Now I want to start my Drone Engage software. I can, by the way, restart the board. So the easy way is to restart the board. Let's see another way. Sudo systemctl start, or restart the same de communication. Here it is. As we can see, now we are connected online, but still you cannot see any flight control available here. That's because this service is not running, and because I'm not connecting a board to this Raspberry Pi Zero. Now I will shut down this Raspberry Pi Zero and go connect the board and turn it on again.